Gangsters were caught or killed. The police and FBI shot down. John Dillinger, Pretty Boy Floyd, Ma Barker and her boys, Clyde Barrow and Bonnie Parker, Babyface Nelson, Harry Pierpoint and Charlie Mackley, the old man, die in Ohio's electric chair. Machine Gun Pop Kelly and Al Capone sent to Alcatraz. Just when the police, the FBI, and J. Edgar Hoover thought everything was under control, two more gangsters came along, and they were Bad Benny and Sure Shot Stella Dixon. Topeka, Kansas is located in the eastern part of the state. It was underneath these skies of Topeka that a guy emerged, and his name was Benjamin Dixon. Benjamin Dixon, or Benny, was born in 1911. He was raised in this house at 517 West 14th Street in Topeka. Benny's father was a school teacher, and his mother was a housewife. They had a comfortable life. Benny had an older brother named Spencer, and they were inseparable. Benny was in the Boy Scout for 8 years, and when he was 12 years old, he saved a girl's life in a local city pond. Benny loved to go to the movies. His favorite actor was the sensational Jimmy Cagney. But then Benny started to get in trouble. In 1926, when he was 15, him and some friends stole a Packard and drove it around the block. The owner pressed charges, and Benny was arrested. He was given 2 years probation. In 1929, Benny beat up a cab driver near this hotel and robbed him of $8. He was given a 10-year prison sentence at the Kansas State Reform School. Benny was paroled in 1931, but that same month got into trouble again when him and two friends robbed a bank in Stotesbury, Missouri. Benny was arrested here at Cage Park in Topeka. This time, Benny was given a 10 to 20 year sentence at the notorious Missouri State Prison, which was also known as the Walls. Some of the most dangerous criminals were incarcerated there. Benny was released in 1937. He was now 27 years old, and he wanted to go straight. He moved back to Topeka to live with his parents, and he searched for honest work. But he wasn't having much luck because of his criminal record. One night, him and his brother Spencer went roller skating, and Benny met a young girl named Stella. She was 15, he was 27. Benny was hired by a local cab company, but he needed a license. So one day he went down to the Topeka City Hall to apply for one. But when the jerko City Hall clerk insulted Benny because of his criminal past, Benny decked him. Benny was facing prison time again, so he decided to take off to California. He ended up in Los Angeles. He lived here at 901 West 36th Street. He rented a house. He thought about Stella every day and wrote to her daily. Stella Mae Irwin was born in 1922. Seen here with her mother Hattie, grew up in hard times. Her father was abusive to the family and left when Stella was only 2 years old. Stella and her mother lived in a one-room shack here at 2401 Clay Street in Topeka. Stella was said to be searching for love and affection, but at times she was angry and moody. Probably your typical teenager. Stella did pretty good in school. She got good grades, and she seemed to be well-liked. When Stella was 15, she was walking home from roller skating one night, and a strange man offered her a ride. That lowlife took her to a secluded place and raped her. Stella contracted gonorrhea from that lowlife, and she was hospitalized. At that time, gonorrhea was very painful to treat, and it was very embarrassing, especially for a young girl, 15 years old. snotty kids at school found out Stella had gonorrhea, and they made fun of her. This was devastating to Stella, and she felt like she were an outcast. So at the age of 16, Stella ran away from home. She went to California to be with Benny. Stella and Benny decided to get married, but because of Stella's age, they had to get married in Pipestone, Minnesota. Now they were man and wife, and they both decided on a life of crime together. Benny and Stella's first robbery occurred in 1938 in Elkton, South Dakota. They got away with around $2,100. Not a bad haul for the first time. They had a secret hideout in Lake Benton, Minnesota. It was an old farmhouse with no electricity. Benny and Stella's second robbery occurred in Brooklyn, South Dakota at the Northwest Security Bank on October 31st, 1938. They got away with around $20,000. They returned to their hideout at Lake Benton, Minnesota.